good. It's all good. We're here.
We're doing it.
Recording. We're
parking enforcement's just ticketing everyone outside.
Yeah,
but
I get a ticket.
Yeah, it's okay.
Hopefully, I mean, it probably won't be that bad anyway. I mean, whatever you have to. Well, I guess the expired plates might be a little high, but I'm sure it won't be that expensive.
Are your plates expired?
Your plates were expired.
Not my plates.
Oh, okay.
Tag.
Still, I'm sure that's hard too.
It's really parking. It's really their fault that mine is, because they sent my tag to the wrong address.
Oh, so really, you do have a good case.
And also, if you go down there to contest ticket, they just hate dealing with people in person. Yeah, so if you show up, they'll usually throw it out.
That's how Gideon. Like parking tickets like that in college was that you actually contest it. The people who did it were also students, so they were like, "Yeah, it's good."
Yeah. Well,
we
watched The Parent Trap.
I really wasn't expecting you to suggest that. You know, I was like,
I just watched it twice recently.
Oh, okay.
And I was like, well, you know, I think I watched it and then I enjoyed it so much I watched it again.
Oh, so you still like it? It still holds up?
Yeah, it still held up. It was fun. But then I started thinking about all the problematic parts of The Parent Trap, and I was like, I feel like I want to talk about this.
I will say that I guess when I was younger, it did seem like a fun movie, but now, as an adult, I'm like, actually, this is kind of messed up, guys. How you handled your children is actually pretty messed up, you know?
Yeah.
I'm like, yeah, you guys should probably be upset with your parents, actually. There's a lot more going on here.
Yeah, and I just had a lot of, 90s, nostalgia. I wanted to watch a movie from the 90s.
Okay, and that's why you watched it.
I think it's fun to see all the because these are the age of these girls are they would be older sisters of my friends. So this is the type, the things they're wearing and stuff. This is what the older kids would wear I thought was really cool.
I think they're about my sister's age. So I did see it because my sister enjoyed The Parent Trap a lot. Seeing it now, it's I guess it's kind of not cool, I guess. You actually think about what their parents did. It's kind of fucked
up.
It's
so, immature and, fucked up and, doesn't really make any sense.
Yeah, it's, exactly. But the, both the twins, they never, no one gives the parents shit. The parents are pretty get away without, getting any grievances against it. They're like, we should get them back together. But no one says, hey, maybe we should probably give them a hard time about this.
It's also if however our parents ended was so bad that they each took a twin so they'd never have to speak again.
It's so weird.
Do we really want them back together?
Yeah, that is weird, because when they did see each other, they hit it off pretty well. Despite hating each other so much, they have not made contact in a decade or anything. When they first meet up again, they, seem to still like each other, so I don't know.
Yeah, they have really interesting chemistry. But yeah, I mean, it is kind of funny, the thought of that they're similar, right? And that they have these similarities and that they think alike and they don't want to admit it, but they think alike to the degree that they haven't spoken in 10 years and they send their kids to the same camp.
Yeah.
Which is don't they have camps in
They do send both these kids, thousand miles away. It's a camp in Maine.
Yeah.
And they send, one from California, one from London. And they never explain the significance of this camp. Like, if it's one thing, it's like, oh, I went to this camp. Your grandmother went to this camp. This is a camp we go to. But just,
yeah, because it's like, it doesn't seem to me. Yeah. I guess there are people that send their kids across the country to camp, but it doesn't seem like super necessary to you.
But it's not like a, I don't know, it's like a prestigious camp. Like
It's not like space. I'm sure it's expensive. It's not
space camp. You know, it's like space camp. It's like, okay, space camp happens here for this reason. It's like a big deal camp. But this is like any camp you can find anywhere.
It seemed like one of those things. It's like, is this like, does this family have a history of going to this camp or something?
That's the only thing I can think of. But ironically, they sent both these twins to this camp.
Camp Walden girls.
It reminded me of Boy Scout camp, because I went to camp for boys, so
was great. I love the camp aspect of it. It's like just this like quintessential summer camp. Like you've got the cabins, you've got the canoeing, you've got the megaphone, you've got the like trumpet waking you up in the morning. Like
bugle, I think, actually.
The bugle.
That's a position in Boy Scout troop, bugler.
That's cute.
A very special position to wake everyone up in the morning and knowing the shit.
How long did Boy Scout camp last?
Boy Scout camp's a week. You go there for a week. But there's other Boy Scout. There's more high adventures that can take like 2 weeks, 3 weeks. But the primary program, regular camp, is like a week.
Nice.
So yeah.
Yeah, this was like an 8-week camp.
Yeah, this is different. Camps are different and stuff. That you could be gone. Yeah, but working at Boy Scout camp, it's like you do it weekly. You do 1 week, not work the other week, work 2 weeks, so.
Going to like camps that are longer, it's really fun because you make like more relationships with people and stuff. Like,
you're closer to people because you guys are just stuck together in the woods with nothing to do.
Yeah. So, but if you like want to do other stuff during the summer, like it's good to like go to like a shorter camp.
You can just not take up too much.
I definitely get the appeal of like the long camp.
Yeah, it's good. Yeah, working at camp, like literally, I was away for like 2 months.
It's really fun.
I didn't like, I had no idea. None of us had any idea what was going on in the world. Anything could happen. I would never have known.
Yeah.
So it's kind of like.
Were you allowed to have phones?
Like we have phones and stuff, but you didn't always have the best reception. Eventually they did. Get like Wi-Fi and stuff, but depending on your carrier, it could have been. I think I had a shitty carrier. I think my phone use was a little bit limited. I guess I couldn't really be on as much as I usually was. But now I think you could probably every camp. I think
we weren't supposed to have phones at the camp I went to.
Well, I went to a camp where I actually was there as a participant. I was way younger. I was like 12, 13, and I don't think I had a phone back. This before like everyone had a cell phone. This was back when I was that age. There weren't smartphones and stuff, so no one really had a phone anyway. So
yeah, like the iPhones became like a problem, I guess. People would still like bring them, but like they would like turn a blind eye during like our rest hour.
Yeah.
But it kind of became this thing that like if they saw it twice, they'd take your phone and like
It's kind of like school, like when the iPhones came out, schools were pretty hard on it. But now everyone embraces technology and all the kids have iPads and stuff. So, you know, everyone kind of gave in to having so much technology around that. It's like,
I wasn't on my phone like for, I don't remember ever really being on my phone at camp.
Yeah.
There's just like no need to.
Yeah. I think I went to, when I went to other camp, I think I had way more reception, but I wasn't like doing much on it. I would just do what I do at work. It's just bullshit. Surfing. Bullshit yeah. around.
But yeah, this was like super 90s, didn't have cell phones, really couldn't talk to your parents all summer.
Yeah. Or, well, you could write them. You could write your letter to your parents. I wrote my sister a letter when I was at camp.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. How'd that go?
I think she sent me one first. She did.
That's
then,
nice.
Then I did get someone to write it for me. And then my mom, when she was volunteering, when I went to Boy Scout camp, she also came to as an adult chaperone. And then, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, well, it's in a Boy Scout troop. You have adult leaders, and yeah. Rolanna was an adult leader.
She was, like, really not going to let you have a wild summer.
Yeah, Boy Scout. No, Rolanna, like, she hikes and stuff, so.
It makes sense.
She was doing her own thing.
Oh,
like,
cool.
It was more, and also, it is different. Back then, I used a wheelchair at camp, so she probably wanted to.
Gotcha.
Supervise that.
Yeah. How is that using a wheelchair? Camp?
My parents got like really big, like legit bike wheels.
Sweet.
So it's like, it's not like a regular wheelchair. It can really, there's not like gravel paths and stuff at camp and whatnot. So yeah, it was fine.
And you were a counselor also.
Yeah, that was years later. I didn't use a wheelchair when I was a counselor or anything.
Yeah.
So, but anyway, I did write the letter. My mom reviewed it. She was like, "You can't send this in the mail." Okay.
What? Like, what'd you say?
I don't know. I just said some jokes, I guess.
Oh.
Yeah, I guess you know.
Typical.
Yeah, you know.
Typical party Marty.
Yeah, you know. But yeah, I liked Boy Scout camp and, yeah. Liked it so much, I went back and worked there.
Hell yeah.
It was a good time. I really, yeah. Big part of, technically, being, working at the Boy Scout camp, technically speaking, because I got my Eagle Scout at 18, then when I was in community college, I had nothing to do, so I was, like, adult leader in the troop, but it's just because I still had friends in the troop.
Yeah.
I was like, I guess I can still come hang out on Mondays.
You're the lax troop leader.
Yeah. I was like, I don't really care, guys. And I could teach merit badges, you know, because, all my friends were gone. So they were gone in college. So I had to occupy myself. So that's why I was an adult leader. And then when I went to, around the time of college, that was when I started working at summer camp. So technically working made me a member of Boy Scouts. So technically speaking, I was a Boy Scout for like 17 or 18 years.
Ooh,
like,
that's overkill.
Yeah, I was there for, yeah. I worked at camp, I wasn't like active in a troop, but because I worked at camp, you're like
Your membership is active.
Yeah, basically. They still send me letters.
Oh, yeah.
But it's like they ask for money. You know how it is. So.
I know how it is.
Yeah, anyway, so.
Yeah, well, I think that this was like Lindsay Lohan's first movie.
Yeah.
I think she did a great job.
It says introducing Lindsay Lohan.
It does kind of make me sad how things worked out for her.
Well, you know, actually, I know things last a few years have been rough, but she did recently sign a Netflix deal. And she has a Christmas movie coming out this December, so she's back, guys.
That's going to be great.
Lindsay Lohan movies are...
I look forward to our review.
Exclusively on Netflix. I sent you, they did a sequel to the 365 Days.
Oh, yeah. I saw that it came up on Netflix.
Yeah, I texted you about it. I know, but
Yeah.
Yeah. Just to tell you.
Yeah.
You didn't reply back.
But yeah, I was busy.
Yeah, yeah, I imagine. I didn't say a note if you know what it is, that's all.
Yeah, I saw it come up on my Netflix. I meant to reply, but
no,
I was
busy. Cool. I just wanted to make sure that you knew.
I haven't watched it yet.
I haven't watched it either. I'll see if it, you know.
We'll see if it holds up.
I think I hear she gets kidnapped by another guy or something. But yeah, another guy, I think, comes in between her and the guy who kidnapped her.
That would make sense.
Yeah, yeah. She's getting kidnapped a lot. But anyway, yeah, Ken, they're there.
Yeah.
It's Lindsay Lohan. Lindsay Lohan.
Yeah.
First movie. She does it pretty well.
Yeah, one thing that they seem to be good at very, like, only child type things. Both of them, poker. That's definitely something you become good at because you're playing with adults and you're not playing with children.
Yeah, technically, I gotta tell you, I don't really know how to play poker. I don't know what I'm doing.
I mean, fencing is a very, rich kid type thing.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't think they did that even correctly in the movie. They're, like, jumping and stuff. I was like, I don't think this is.
I don't think you're really supposed to do that.
Yeah, I feel like this is fencing rules. Yeah, fencing, sleeping with a stuffed animal, right?
That's just one of them. That's just Hallie.
Yeah, Hallie. If they made, only reason they made one British is so we can tell them apart. That's
really, I watched an interview with Lindsay Lohan. Do you have a favorite? Do you like Annie or Hallie better?
Who do I like better? I guess Annie, which one's
Annie's the British one. Hallie is the American.
Maybe Annie.
Interesting. So I really liked Hallie. Like, wow. I thought she was so cool with her pierced ears. And horse.
Hallie started the beef.
Yeah.
Fuck you.
She's a California girl. But I thought it was interesting that Lindsay Lohan, I watched an interview with Lindsay Lohan talking about looking back on The Parent Trap. And she said that she liked Annie the best.
Oh, that's why.
She liked her clothes.
Oh, yeah. She dressed nicer.
Yeah, and I thought that was interesting because Hallie was kind of like the bad girl.
Yeah, I guess. And terms with this film, she was a bad girl.
She had more of an edge.
She started shit. Started the shit.
She had a bit more of an edge.
Yeah, she had the better praying. Fair.
Yeah. The prank is fun. The booby trap.
Yeah, go all out on that one.
Yeah, I read an article about how difficult that scene was to film.
Yeah, I'm sure. They had to set it up with all the string and all this stuff. Like, I didn't know how a 10-year-old child could set that up, to be honest.
Yeah.
Good credit to those kids for... Yeah, you gotta admire the craftsmanship here.
Yeah, and to be able to do all that and not wake them up.
Yeah, that also, so...
Yeah.
But yeah, they do all these pranks.
Anyway, all the pranks come to a head, and then they get sent to
the isolation cabin.
Isolation cabin. I thought it was really mean that her having to swim naked, dive into the lake naked, and them taking her clothes.
Yeah, but that's a old movie trope.
It's just an old camp. Thing.
You've seen that before. They're someone's in the locker room or something, and they steal their clothes. I don't know if anyone actually does that. I never had it happen to me or anything.
That's
so
good.
Yeah, that would be so embarrassing.
So they get sent to the isolation cabin, and it seems like they can't really do any of the activities, really.
It seems like they're there for the rest of camp.
Yeah, I'd be really pissed as a parent. It's also very 90s that, they wouldn't call the parents.
I was gonna say, I did think, if they were in enough trouble, wouldn't they just send them home? Right? If you're in that much trouble.
Today, they would at least call the parents.
Yeah.
I don't know if they would get sent home yet for that, but
yeah, I'm saying, well, it seems like their punishment's like, you're not doing anything.
Yeah. But today they call the parents. Like, that's very 90s to send the kids to the isolation cabin and just like never.
Today they would send like a daily, almost daily email to the parents. Like, oh, hey, this is what Billy's doing today. He did, he did really good at archery, you know, some poor communication.
Yeah, I think dealing with the parents would just be awful.
Yeah, it probably nowadays, a kid probably has an Instagram page. They're going to post pictures of your kid. Yeah. You can check out their story. They're on Twitter. More interactive with the parents, you know.
I thought that, that was my, and they like in the mess hall, they're like sitting at the isolation table. Like they can't even sit with like other girls during meals.
Yeah. It's pretty, that's how being the isolation cabin is how they got closer together.
And then they
figure it out
that, my gosh, they're twins.
I do think it's weird. I know it's a crazy idea to be like, do I have a long lost twin? But like these people are like exactly alike. Like you didn't, you weren't even kind of.
I would start asking the questions when I run into someone that looks exactly like me. It wouldn't take like, oh, we're just hanging out and chatting and like, oh, like you don't have a mom. I don't have a dad. Like what? Like I would be asking those questions the second I saw someone that looked exactly like me at
like,
camp.
They're more than like doppelgangers. It's just like, and I'm sure other people at camp had to be like, yo, what the, are they related? Like this is like, there's no way you're not related. Like,
yeah.
They're so genetically.
And they're both like, allergic to strawberries.
Yeah, yeah. So way genetically you're not related. That's not
even. But yeah, and then they have like the one photo of their parents on the ocean liner.
They both happen to bring a cat with them. They both happen to bring the root photo of their parents.
Which, if that's like your prized possession, I don't think I would bring it to camp with me.
I did not
bring like prized possessions with me.
Yeah, I don't think I had any personal item. It is part of the regular camp thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, it wasn't. I didn't like decorate the tent.
Yeah.
It was the, yeah, but
I guess if you're there all summer, you're more apt to do that.
Yeah, but I'm sure you had better picture of your parents. Like, don't you want a picture of you with your parents, or do you just want some?
Well, if you don't have that.
But no, but they have a picture of their parent.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm sure they have a picture of the more better picture of their mom or dad.
No, they don't.
No, but that red picture.
Yeah. Hallie has a picture of her mom and Annie has a picture of her dad.
Okay.
They have the opposite parent.
Okay. I thought they had a picture of the parent they had.
No.
Okay.
That's what they said. That's why they like are like, I only have one photo of like dad. It's crumpled and wrinkled. And then she's like, I only have one photo of my mom.
I forgot that. Okay. But that makes even more sense that, yeah, you wouldn't bring the one picture you have of your father to summer camp. That makes even more. That doesn't make sense. Yeah, it's like, your one picture you've ever had.
But a great cinematic moment when they put the photos together and you realize they're twins. Yeah, I mean, their parents clearly didn't know each other better because they were on an ocean liner that was from like London to New York. Yeah. And I looked it up and that lasts like a week.
It takes a week. So I'm assuming an ocean liner is like a smaller cruise.
Yeah, and they seem to have like met and gotten married. On the ocean liner. That was what it seemed to allude.
Yeah. So that's why it didn't work out because they were only.
Yeah, I was like, well, you guys don't even know each other.
Yeah.
And then it seems that they. I mean, they don't say how long they were together before they had the kids, but I assume less than a year.
But it seems like they also divorced and separated like literally right after their twins were born.
Yeah, like they come home from the hospital, divorce.
Like they were already like during the pregnancy, he was like, I can't make this work. Once you give birth, I'm fucking out of here, okay?
Yeah.
Because they haven't been together for 10 or 11 years, and their children are 10 or 11 years old. So it seems like right when that happened, it's like, okay, they're out. Okay, we gotta end it. But
yeah.
Even their reasoning was weird, because it's like, they're like, okay, we can't make this work, because then our children are going to live 1 year in London and then live another year in California.
It's like, you're going to have to live closer together.
Yeah. So it's like their parents didn't want to give up on their dreams. That's what happens.
It's like, I think your dreams are very mobile, actually.
The
vineyard, maybe less so, but I mean, they certainly make wine other places besides California, but also there are designers
everywhere.
Yeah. In like America.
Yeah. So, well, she seems like a very prestigious, well-known fashion designer.
I'm pretty sure you can still do that.
Yeah. I'm sure they're close to San Francisco. That's a major city. I'm sure.
Yeah. I'm sure.
Set up there. But yeah, so anyway, but this, the reason didn't make sense, where it's like, yeah, we don't want to put our children through that, and we're not moving, so the healthiest...
So instead, they'll just never know.
Yeah. Not only, well, you never know you have a sibling, but you also never know your mother or your father.
Yeah.
That's the healthiest thing, I think, we have come to turn. It's just like, and then everyone in their family, like, because the grandfather lives with the mother, he knows about it, their butler knows about it.
Everyone figures it out pretty quickly, I'd say.
Yeah, but they already know about the setup.
Yeah, they know about the set, yeah. But like when they switch places, I will say it, yeah. Everyone well, figures that out pretty quickly, except for like the actual parents.
It proves that the nanny and the butler are actually raising the kids.
Yeah. That's, I would say so.
Yeah, it seems like, okay, we know. Yeah. And the grandfather, I guess.
It proves how absent the parents really are. Yeah, when they're again,
their dreams, they were career driven. This is what happens. You say, yeah, I don't know. It seems pretty messed up that you could just like you don't have any remorse giving up your kid. Like, it's like they're just like, oh, they're twins. It's like
I feel like I would, if I did something like that, I would lie awake every night thinking like, about it. And then I'd just be like, all right, this isn't going to work. Yeah, if I even got to that point.
Yeah, yeah, it's like really, it's still like your kid. It's still kind of messed up.
It's super fucked
up. Yeah, it's like... Yeah, I don't know, like, no one, has anyone ever addressed this? I feel like this is the first time where I'm like, yeah, this is pretty a terrible decision their parents made, and no one calls them out on it. They're just like, yeah, it's what we had to do, guys.
It's like, was there no one in anyone's, like, in their lives to be like, hey, this is a terrible idea, you're gonna regret?
Yeah, I don't know, it seems just crazy. Yeah, now that I think about it now as an adult, I was like, yeah, it's bad. This is absolutely outrageous. Like,
yeah.
If you read about this, it's like, this is like, yeah, a terrible news story.
I would like to see, like, 5 years later, the psychological effects rearing its head, because it's like, it's all well and good, but it's like, you're going to start to resent your parents so much.
For not, just for...
For doing, like, the dumbest thing.
Yeah. It's just, bad. I don't know. It seems crazy that no one's ever... And the girls are never angry at their... Like, the girls are right from the start. Why when they figure it out? Like, oh, let's get them back together. And nobody was like, man, your dad was... I can't believe your dad did that. I can't believe mom and dad did this to us, really. There's never really a scene where they're really upset.
Yeah, I think I would have been on the phone being like, what the fuck?
Yeah, exactly.
At
yeah.
camp and I have a twin.
Yeah, what's going
Start
on?
Start talking.
Yeah, but there's never that scene. They're just like, well, let's bring them back together. Let's be a family. And it's like, I feel like most people may try to do that, but also with their first reaction, it's probably more upset. And
it's good that they're both rich, though.
Oh, yeah. This is definitely not a prince and pauper situation.
Yeah, it's good they're both rich yeah. because that would really suck.
Yeah, they both have a pretty good life. Like, they switch places, but just to have a different rich experience. Like,
yeah.
One's like in City of Loudon, the other one's like, you know, the California.
The Rolling Hills. Napa Valley.
Yeah, Napa Valley. So I think they're both doing pretty well either way. They're both, you know, who knows? Maybe one of the twins is like, yeah, I just want to stay here, actually. You know what? Forget the whole plan. I'll just stay in London. It's cool.
I feel like that's sort of what Hallie was like trying to do.
Yeah.
She's like, I need more time with mom. I'm having a great time. Goodbye.
Yeah.
Classic phone closet.
Oh, yeah.
Candy wrapper pretending to have static. Yeah. Great scene.
Yeah. But they find it out. So, of course, they do the switcheroo. They switch places. Hallie, they get to know each. They study each other. They get the British accent. And they, Annie has shorter hair.
Annie has long hair. Yeah. Hallie has short hair and pierced ears.
And Hallie cuts that
Hallie.
Hair. Hallie cuts that hair perfectly. Like, she cuts it. And it's
it
like
was impressive.
Yeah, I was like, damn, dude. Like, I gotta hand it to you. And then they have to get
because she probably has an expensive haircut.
Yeah. And like, I remember it was one time I thought I'd give myself a haircut. I like cut my bangs, and it was so high that I had to get a haircut. I had a very high bowl cut. It was like a fryer or something.
When they have to go fix it.
Yeah, I had to go fix it. So it's not that easy to cut hair. And then they do the classic, let's pierce our ears ourselves, you know?
Yeah.
And they just,
I remember being so scared of that scene when I was a little kid.
Yeah, it's definitely a lot. The needle, you have to heat it and do it really fast, like an apple right there.
I thought it was the scariest thing.
Yeah, I mean, I imagine. So you never tried it yourself? You never?
I've pierced my own ears.
Oh, so you did do it.
I didn't do it with like a needle and an apple.
How did you do it?
Because you can, when you get your ears pierced, like when they pierce it with a gun, like it's already sharp. The earring. So you can skip the needle essentially if you sterilize the earring and then just like pierce it.
So you just get an earring and put it through?
Well, it's like a special type of earring that's sharp like a needle.
Oh.
Yeah.
You just get that and did it?
Yeah, because you keep it when you like because I got my ears pierced for the first time.
So they were already pierced.
Yeah, so I did like a second hole.
Yeah.
Third hole.
Oh, yeah. But you did that yourself?
I did like the third hole myself.
Oh, okay. And it didn't get infected?
No, because I sterilized it with like rubbing alcohol.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah. I don't think I'm an ears pierced.
I don't think so either.
I don't think.
I think the needle with the match was a little overkill. I was like, I'm sure you
sterilize
can.
It.
Yeah, but I was like, I'm sure you can find rubbing alcohol.
You're at a camp.
At camp.
Yeah.
Like.
Yeah.
There's a first aid kit. There's probably a first aid kit in this cabin.
Exactly. I know people who tattoo themselves with the needle like that.
Yeah, like a prison tattoo.
Yeah, basically, but they weren't in prison. But
I think I forget what you're supposed to call it.
Yeah, it's like John Hendrick had a friend, and he's like trying to be a tattoo artist, so he's literally practiced on John. And I was like, I don't want this guy to practice. Like, it's not gonna look good.
Does he have like a
I guess, yes, some type of kitty practice on. Yeah, he had a better-looking tattoo. John had a better-looking tattoo on him than just a regular needle.
I've seen some, like, pretty good ones.
Yeah, well, I don't...
I'm not super interested in doing that.
Yeah, I don't want, like, an amateur guy if I get it, you know, so... And also, it's still getting infected, so...
Yeah.
You know, also, I don't know if I'm a tattoo guy. I don't like needles. I'm actually very afraid of needles. I didn't like getting shots. I've never given blood, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not into needles at all.
My ears have got, my ears have gotten infected before. Yeah, not like right after they were pierced, but yeah, I've never had a problem with a tattoo, though.
Yeah, I think my sister also had infected ears before, but. Yeah. I could have got the gauges, but I don't think that was my look either.
No. Really? Usually you can handle it yourself pretty well if you, like, keep it clean.
Yeah. I don't know. It's just not me, Liz.
Yeah. One thing I was sort of interested that they sort of didn't address in the movie is whether the dad had other, like...
Ladies. She said, like, they, like, came down for her, you know, this guy never dates or anything. And then she has this, this young woman who was there. She's there for business, though.
She's, like, hired, she's, like, a publicist, and I guess she's doing, like, marketing for the vineyard.
Yeah, so already not really good.
Which is already super unprofesh.
Yeah, it's, you know, low-key. And also, I think he's, like, 20 years older than she is.
Definitely.
She says she's 26. She's probably 45, 46. But also, it mirrors life, because... Dennis Quaid, who was like 63, did marry a 27-year-old.
Yeah, he is like very young.
Oh, yeah, dude. But isn't that cool, guys? Yo.
Elaine Hendricks is awesome.
That's who he married?
No, who played Meredith Blake.
Oh. Oh, the bad guy. Yeah, yeah. The actress.
Yeah, she's awesome. I've listened to some podcasts. She's been on and stuff. She's super cool.
The nanny lady is pretty cool.
Yeah, they're really good friends.
Jesse. I hear so pretty.
I thought for like a decade it was Jesse.
Jesse is not really pop. I've never heard the name Jesse before. Yeah. Anyway. I also like the butler is cool too. I like the butler. They had a good relationship. Martin. Yeah, it's Martin also. So already solid.
Yeah, that's a fun like B storyline.
Yeah, they end up together. The nanny and the butler, of course. Yeah. But anyway, yeah, so her dad's actually dating someone. And I mean, you know, I guess they haven't known each other that long, but he's like...
Yeah, it seems they've only known each other how long she's been at camp, which is 2 months.
Yeah.
Which is insane that he would be, like, engaged to her already. But clearly, historically, he moves fast.
Yeah, I guess he did marry his first wife in a week.
Yeah.
You know, he's gonna... You know, he gave us more time this time, though. Yeah. Instead of a week, he gave it, like, 8 weeks. So, let's, you know, he's doing better, I guess, but at first, Meredith was really nice, but then, you know, Annie really rubbed her the wrong way, and she was like, I'm sending these kids to boarding school. Mm-hmm. So at first she was nice at first, okay? I think it was really how Annie treated her that made her turn so quickly.
Yeah.
I think if they were not, I mean, I understand they don't want her to like
marry. I was kind of like, okay, like she is the adult and she like sucks, but also you are a brat. And if you've been nicer to her, I wonder.
Yeah, I mean, I understand.
If you could have had a better relationship.
Yeah, I understand you want to not have her marry your dad, but. Now there's a way you could go around it, maybe a little more mature, okay, you know.
Yeah. Girl. She did seem to try at first.
Yeah, and then she despised them, and, you know.
Yeah.
So don't be upset if Meredith's not the villain. That's what we're trying to say here. Don't play Meredith, guys.
I don't really think she did anything super wrong, except for like wanting to send them to boarding school in Switzerland.
Yeah,
that was uncalled for.
That was a bit extreme.
But they did like really fuck with her.
Yeah, they put her inflatable mattress in the lake when she was sleeping.
Also, that's so dangerous for someone to take a sleeping pill and then their mattress, like...
I forgot she took a sleeping pill.
Yeah, that's so dangerous. I'm like, this could have been very different. And this could have been like a hiding a body movie.
Yeah, this could have been like Young Murderers. Could have switched so quickly. But they get found out and then... They get her mom to go to California. I forget where they go because the mom knows. That's right, the mom.
Yeah, I was like, okay, so you're going to California to switch them back, and you haven't spoken on the phone to their dad.
Yeah,
are you really gonna do that? I'm like, I think you would have a phone call first.
It's definitely like a very serious situation.
Yeah, like this is.
It's pretty something you probably.
Regardless of your history, I don't think you would just show up in California.
Apparently they really hated each other, so it seemed like.
So you're just gonna see them in person. A phone call is easier.
Switch it really fast or something, but yeah, that's a good point. So. Yeah, the mom finds out, like, okay, we're going to go to California, we're going to switch it. And then they do see each other again. Again, they hit it off pretty good.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, maybe, I don't know why we separated so long.
So it
seems like they needed to do that.
No. Also, this movie... is what ignited my love of like Bloody Marys, because when the mom is like hungover at the bar and they give her a Bloody Mary for like hair of the dog or whatever. I was like, that's so cool that she's hungover.
Yeah.
That's so chic.
That's totally. Yeah. Totally.
And now I love Bloody Marys and I think about her every time.
Yeah. Wow. You get to live your fantasy.
Yeah.
Wow. I always thought they were kind of gross, but...
Yeah, I think they can be really good.
Yeah, that's just me. I'll take tomato soup. Anyhow. But yeah, they're back, and they meet up, yada yada. And then when it's like, okay, we're going back home.
Well, the fall in the pool is a classic scene.
Yeah, yeah. Because he's so... struck in by her, he has to go see her.
So shocked.
It doesn't matter what's in front of him, what obstacles in the way, and they tease it like three times. Is he gonna fall in the pool? Then he finally does.
Yeah, excellent cinema.
Yeah, it really is like iconic scene. I believe they used it in the commercial for it. I think it's in the trailer.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, it's in the very way. Yeah, so they all meet up.
And then the twins they put on the same outfit, refuse to tell them, which one is which, and say that, they won't tell them unless they all go on the family camping trip together.
Yeah, it's supposed to be as a family, but then the dad invites Meredith.
Well, no, that's not what happens.
No, wait, the mom invites Meredith.
Yeah, and then doesn't go.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Which was some scheming on her part.
But she didn't want to go anyway because she was like, this isn't going to work.
Well, I think she did some scheming and she was like, I don't need to fuck up this. If Meredith goes on this camping trip, she's going to fuck it up.
I mean, sure. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, which I guess she does really. I mean, she fucks it up because the girls fuck with her, so.
Yeah.
And so I really.
I mean, she didn't seem to really be into the camping experience.
Yeah.
But also, to be fair, that's kind of an extreme first camping trip.
Go
like
backpacking.
Yeah. Essentially backpacking and with altitude changes.
Yeah. And mountains.
Like, maybe try car camping first.
Or just, like, just literally, yeah, not, like, park your car in the campsite's right there.
That's car camping.
Oh, that's what I thought you meant, actually staying in your car.
No, okay. Car camping is when you drive into a site.
Okay, fair. That's, yeah, I agree with
that. Yeah, I think that would have been more her speed.
Just more glamping.
Yeah.
More of a glamping.
That's not really glamping, just like, I think she would have done better not, and like having things to eat besides having to fish for your food.
Yeah, that's even part of it. Even if you do it, like, even if you go backpacking, like, you bring other food.
Yeah, come on. Because you don't, like, what if you don't catch anything?
Yeah, you can't earn your keep here. I don't know, I think barely it's probably more hotel camping, to be honest.
Also, she's in such good shape. I, like, have a hard time believing she would have had that difficult of a time on the hike.
Besides the altitude, maybe.
Yeah. I was like, they seem to, like, make it seem like she's really out of shape, and she's not.
Yeah, I think.
I don't know if she would have struggled that much.
Well, altitude can mess you up, but besides...
But, like, but Annie's not struggling. I feel like Annie...
Yeah, the girls seem to be doing fine. Well. Yeah, like,
even like, I feel like Annie doesn't really do this.
Yeah, that's true. Annie is more of a glam bird as well.
Yeah, I don't know.
But they all have a good time, I guess. And the dad doesn't even care, really. He's like, hey, girls, knock it off.
Yeah. Right?
They're doing all these pranks to her, even with the... putting her in bed in the leg. He's like, that's my girl, you know.
Yeah. I mean, he defended them to, like, her.
Yeah, because, well, once you wake up in a lake, you know, you're gonna be upset, you know. It's like,
yeah,
it's you know, that's a pretty, you know, I'd be pretty mad too. But then she loses that. She's like, okay, it's me or them. And of course he's gonna go with his
kids.
Yeah, yeah, even though one of them he hasn't seen for a while.
Yeah, so I mean, he basically indicates to them that he's not gonna marry Meredith.
Yeah,
and that's over. The last we see of her.
She's gone, she leaves.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's over.
And then they're back at the house, and we get to have that little moment in the wine cellar when we realize that he's bought, like, every bottle of that wine from the year they got married.
Yeah, and he has that wine.
Yeah.
I think they used all the airliner.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he's always kept 83, I remember.
Yeah.
Then they actually go back on the airliner because the girls use their grandfather's money to rent it to get a night. Yeah. They have dinner on there, they trick their parents, they're having dinner together, and even that, they're like, we can't.
That was before all that. That was, like, when they were still at the hotel.
Okay, it's the sequencing is out of place. But anyway, they do that, so I guess after...
They recreate the night they met, they go on the camping trip.
Yeah, it didn't work. So I guess after the camping, they're still going to leave, so...
Yeah.
And then he was like, okay, yeah, that's it. I guess we're going back to London. Sorry. Still can't be a
fan.
And they
still don't seem to have worked out the visiting schedule if they're going to see each other.
It was like, yeah.
Because that was brought up on when they recreated the night they met. And Chessie was like, guys, Chessie and Martin are, like, the hostess.
Yeah.
Host and hostess.
Yeah.
And
waiters.
And Chessie was like, guys, it's not gonna work. That doesn't make any sense. But they don't seem to have come up with another plan.
They're basically like, I guess this all won't work. Okay.
Yeah. Well, and they're just like, okay, I'll see you Christmas and then Easter.
Yeah.
It's like, well, that's not really a good plan.
Basically, Thanksgiving, we'll keep in touch. The girls can talk on the phone.
Yeah.
And then they leave, they go to London. They go back home, and when they get home, guess what? Oh, Haley's there.
Hallie.
Damn it. Hallie's there. And her dad. And her dad's like, I should have chased you that one time, the first time you left. Now I'm here. And then, they get that.
And they make out in front of their 11-year-old children.
Yeah, well, he was already... making out when there it is. So,
yeah. There's a lot of making out in front of the kids.
Yeah. But I like the ending. It's always a fun ending where it ends in like snapshot.
Yeah, no, it's a great ending. Yeah, yeah, no, it's just like, it's a great, it's such a fun movie. There's so many fun moments. Yeah,
it's like they take a negative and make it into a positive.
The pranks, the snapshots.
Yeah. I'm saying, because the actual story of what the parents said was pretty negative, but they make it a positive the whole time. Yeah. So you don't think about like, oh, wait, that's kind of messed up.
It's also an example of sometimes you can just enjoy a movie. You don't have to analyze and unpack single thing.
Yeah, but why wear this hat? This is for analyzing
cinema.
You really have to become Lindsay Lohan to really understand what.
But I will say, out of all the characters, Meredith Blake is probably the most iconic one that people will still do things and then like post like I know multiple people who have done like the red nail, gotten the sunglasses. Okay.
Did the lizard thing.
There are like people who, when they turn 26, they call it their Meredith Blake year. Like she's canon, you know?
Yeah, it's just iconic role.
Yeah, it is an iconic role.
Yeah, people still put a lizard in their mouth. People still...
Evian product placement.
Yeah. They still wake up in the lake. They still...
Yeah. And what is like, there are like some fun, there's some fun kind of like callbacks to the original.
Yes.
Like Let's Get Together is a song from the original, and in the hotel, Hallie's humming it at one point.
Okay. Yeah.
And then Meredith's mother, Vicky, is from the original movie and played her role in
so even the original is still played away one person, like no twins have ever played
Haley Mills I watched the original this year too.
Did you like it as much?
Yeah, I mean, like, I really enjoy both. I think the remake, it's one of the few remakes that where it's like, it holds up. It's like good on its own.
Yeah,
and really, they did some fun like homages to like the original.
Yeah, they did.
I feel like we're at the point where like, you know, it's been like what.
Been 20 years.
It's been 20 years. Like, are they gonna
Disney Plus, you know, they remake remaking stuff. So
yeah,
there's been a new Home Alone, a new Cheaper by the Dozen. They're cranking them out. So I could imagine the Parent Trap could.
I was like, are they gonna remake it? I kind of hope they don't, just because I think the two are great, but. I could see it being time for a remake.
Yeah, they definitely,
It's one of those movies where it is cool that multiple our generation had theirs, and then like my mom's generation had theirs.
Yeah.
And so it was like,
so we need the next generation.
Yeah, it is fun to have that.
Yeah, it's fun. Then the mom in the film died because she hit her head while skiing. So
I didn't realize Natasha Richardson had died like that.
Yeah, well,
I just had never given her much thought.
I didn't know it was her, but I knew that's how Liam Neeson's wife died, and I was like, oh, that's who his wife was.
That's really sad. She's so lovely.
You hit your head. So yeah, if you hit your head, go to the doctor, guys.
Yeah,
your head hurt. That's how Bob Saget died, except he wasn't skiing. He just hit his head somehow.
Yeah, if you hit your head really hard, go seek medical attention.
Yeah, because you could be internal bleeding.
Yeah,
in the brain. So
yeah.
Anyway,
it's really sad.
Yeah, but PSA, guys. So anyway, yeah. So
I think that when it comes down to is it romantic or not, I would say yes.
Oh.
There's some underlying problematic things about the movie, but also we don't have to analyze every single part of this movie. We can just enjoy it and say, this is fiction.
Yeah. You know, it's, you know, amateur filmmaking.
Not everything is to be emulated in real life, but it's like a fun.
Yeah. It's,
and also aside from that, there's nothing super problematic about this movie. Really?
So it's the treatment of children, but
I mean, like, in terms of like how it holds up, right? Yeah, yeah. You don't watch it and there's no one who's gonna be like,
it is basically just like rich white people,
but there's nothing like, no one says anything problematic. There's
rich.
Nothing that happens in the movie that like an actor has to apologize for. Yeah,
all the actors have been, it's going to go ahead and went through a rough spot, but she's good now. Netflix deal, guys. Dennis Quaid has young life. He's killing it. So
it sucks that Lindsay Lohan,
you know how it is.
It's sad to kind of watch what sort of happened in her career, but to see her young like this with so much promise and no plastic surgery.
Yeah. Well, you know.
But you know, life happens.
I think her actual parental situation was just as worse as this one, I think.
She definitely didn't always have the right people advocating for her.
Yeah, her dad looks scary. Her scared dad is like, oh, this guy would start a fight at a bar. Is that and her mom looks like she probably has got plastic surgery or something. Should I summarize this in a minute? Or
let's do it.
I think you did it last time. But anyway.
Sorry, I am starting the clock now.
Okay, this was about two twins who are separated at birth because their parents couldn't stay together, so they go to summer camp ironically in San Juan and meet up with each other and get to know each other. Then they realize they have the same parents, and then they switch roles, and one goes with the mom, the other and the dad, and they try to get them back together. They get found out, and the dad's going to marry someone, so the mom finds out. They go back and do the switcheroo again, and they sabotage his new fiance, and then they try to get their parents back together, and it didn't look good. But at the end, he flies to her, he chases after her, because that's what every woman wants, is a guy to chase after her. And then, once he knows that, they're back together, and they're a family.
Nice.
So, that's it. So, sorry for the delay in episodes, guys. We were both on our own trips. We got sick, but we'll be back, I think, to our bi-weekly schedule.
Yep.
Yeah, so.
Cool.
Yeah, next time, I don't know, maybe we'll do a movie. There's a documentary I saw about a guy who died fucking a horse, It was like, this man.
Maybe that's just something you can watch yourself.
It's really interesting. I gotta tell you, it's more interesting than you think, because he wasn't about the horse, though. He got a motorcycle accident, and then he had trouble, getting off, so then he needed stimulation from huge penises, and horses have the biggest penis, so he was in it for the penis, not the horse. So that's Mr. Hands. Do you know that internet video?
No.
Oh, it came out around the time we were in high school. It was a viral video.
No.
I guess you weren't there to watch.
What year did that come out?
Like 06.
I would have been middle school, so
still, it's
my internet access was pretty restricted.
Yeah, and you see the one where the guy chops off his dick?
No, I haven't seen any of these.
Okay, it was. I mean, I didn't see the horse one till like a year or so ago, and so on. I heard about it.
Okay,
it was like early internet. You didn't remember the early internet days.
I do remember, but like I haven't seen these videos.
Yeah, I think I saw the other wild ones. But anyway, that's it was very interesting documentary.
Interesting.
Thought, yeah.
Where is that?
It's free on YouTube, guys. It's
okay.
Yeah, it's people. It's called Zoo. It's about it's what the group of people are called. Who?
Cool.
Yeah. So.
All right. Well, you want to take us out?
See you next week, Karen. See you next time.
Have a good week, yeah, Ron Bros.
See you guys.
Don't fuck a horse.
Yes, exactly.